let's take a look at some additional patch attributes that can be applied to channels.
Let's begin by going back into patch. I'm going to double tap my address patch button. First, we'll want to touch on our attribute softkey to get into that section of patch. In our CIA, we'll see several things we can modify. First, we're going to look at preheat. Preheat is a flag we can apply to a queue that will preheat channels in the previous queue to a level we specify here in patch. So this is a two-step function, the first step being here in patch. For example, if we wanted to preheat channel 1, we could select channel 1, touch preheat. I'm going to preheat this one to 3%. So I will have to type a leading 0 before my 3, just like in live. Enter. Now if we go to live, and for example, if we wanted to preheat this in Q4, we would say Q4 attributes preheat, enter. You'll see in your PSD a capital P in the preheat column of our flags display. In this example, channel 1 will preheat to a level of 3% in the queue immediately preceding our queue. In this case, it would preheat in Q3 before going to its value assigned in Q4. Let's go back into patch. The next attribute we're going to look at is proportion. So let's select channel 2 this time and touch proportion. We can assign any value between 0 and 200 here. This will tell the console to proportionally output this level at all times compared to the level seen in our live display. So for example, if I have a set of front lights and one of them accidentally was lamped at a 750 watt lamp instead of a 575 watt lamp, I could come in here and say proportion 77%, because I know that's the mathematical difference between those two lamps. And anytime this light was set to full, it would actually be outputting 77%. If I needed to boost a light, I could put in a value higher than 100, for example, 150%, which would mean the light would always go 50% higher than the stated value in live. Obviously, a light can't go higher than full, but anytime that channel is less than full, it will be increased by the proportion determined here. The next thing we're going to look at is curves. Let's press our displays button and then our curve soft key there. A curve affects how a fade happens over time. There are several built-in curves that come with the console. Let's take a look at 905. You can type it in or use your next button to get down there. In our CIA, you'll see the input and output values listed along with a graph. The input values is what will be displayed in live and what we're putting into our queues. The output value is what the console is actually putting out in DMX value. So in this example, when the channel is at 0, it will be outputting 0. But when the channel is at any other level, 1 through full, the DMX output will actually be 100%. This would be a good curve to use on a relay or something that you only wanted to turn on or off. Back in patch, to apply a curve, we'll say channel 3, enter. We'll touch our curve button. We can either type in 905, or you'll see that our CIA has populated with the curves available. So I can touch 905 there. I will also point out that curve 909 is a great curve to use for relays that are powering moving lights or LED fixtures. With curve 909, your output of that channel will always be full. So no matter what the console's telling that channel to do, it's going to be on. To remove a curve, simply touch the curve box and press enter. LD flags is a toggle that can be enabled or disabled per channel. This will disable the live move and dark move displays from appearing in your PSD. GM exempt or grandmaster exempt is a setting you can apply on a per channel basis that will exempt any specified channel from being affected by a grandmaster, a blackout button, or remdim. This will also prevent channels from being affected by go to queue out and go to queue zero operations. The next ones we want to look at are invert pan and invert tilt. Let's jump back into live for a moment, and we're going to turn on group 7 to full. These fixtures right now, they all tilt together and pan together. Depending on how our fixtures are hung, in this case, they're in two vertical rows from downstage to upstage, it might help us to switch these around to make them a little easier to control. I'm going to go back into patch, and I want to invert our stage left fixtures. So I'm going to say group 7, offset 2 to grab every other fixture. And I want to invert the pan and the tilt on these fixtures. Now let's go back to live. I'm going to say group 7, select those. Now when I tilt them, they go opposite from each other. And when I pan them, they track each other upstage and downstage. For the purposes of my programming this show, I think I'm going to be a lot happier with that. Another example is to take group 5, full room dim. These are our front of house fixtures. Go ahead and tilt them up on stage. And now when I pan, I notice that my encoder wheel moving to the left actually takes the fixtures to the right, and vice versa. I'd really like that to be the opposite. So we can jump back into patch, select 101 through 105. We're going to invert their pan. Come back into live, select last, and now they pan the way that my brain thinks they should. This is definitely something you should do before you start queuing your show.